So when you look at an application like Walling, it has some interesting functionality, and from a free version, I don't like the fact that it doesn't give you as much as something like Notion. You don't get a myriad of options in the free version, or on Notion, you literally just have unlimited pages. Whereas here, you get like 100 of those pages or bricks. And the way that Walling works is it's actually kind of a Google Keep sort of on steroids, I would say. It's Google Keep with better brainstorming functionality. And the thing is, you need to have premium to have due dates and reminders or unlimited file uploads. And a lot of that's pretty standard stuff. But just as a quick mention, this thing doesn't have an API and hopefully it will soon. But there are some good things about Walling. So let's dive into that right now. So some of the features that you can have here, if you look at like these really well done templates that they have out here. This is like an example project management one. You can add covers to things just from an aesthetic standpoint. You can change it from light to dark mode really easily within the application. It looks nice. It's a very nice looking application. And as you can see here, this is a project management sort of template that they have where you can take different things and move them. As you can see, there are different views. From a visual standpoint, there are nice little sections that you can have from this sort of wall brick visual layout, and then there are lists and there are table views. And on each wall, which is like a main workspace on anything, you can have bricks, which then are put into sections. As you can see, there are different sections here. You can section different walls off as well, outside of just the literal like statuses that are an option for columns within a wall. And I like the fact that you can actually look on this application for different things, like this tasks and bookmark page are actually a pretty nice view of how, like, you can have gallery stuff in Notion. However, this is a little bit above a gallery view where, like, you can interact with this stuff in the gallery view without having to go into it. Like, this more looks like what the gallery view is in Notion, right? Where this is a bookmark. Let's pretend it was a page and I'd have to click into it. Whereas this is what Walling ends up doing. It's like Google Keep and Notion had a baby, and then the baby was mildly less adequate than one of the parents. But it does work really fast, and you can see here that there are different options for things like checklists and text, headings, similar to what happens in Notion, just not as well deeply linked. And there are some linking to different wall options that you can have, like you can take this and link it to one of the other workspaces, and then I could like quickly go and navigate between the two. So there is a lot of different functionality here, and just from a nice perspective, if I took one of these and pinned it, I could show you what's going on here. So this task and bookmark page is actually a good example. If I take some different things here and just add it to the pin section, and then I could look here, this is your daily desk. And this daily desk kind of just has a nice space where if you have ideas on the day, you can drop them in the daily desk, and then you can add things like different daily ideas, change recording setup. As you can see, I have a different setup from like the last part of the year where I was doing screen recording, so that's an example. And then add a lamp maybe behind me, just trying to get some ideas for like what's going on. So this is a nice visual look of that sort of things. But then there is a pinned section where you can have different things pinned and move them around. So this could be moved into YouTube, this could be moved into work. On the bottom here, as you can see, you can either drag them, or actually an option here if I want to give an example is move to section that's on the same page, and then like podcast, and then same idea here. I could just leave here and this would be the recent one. And then as well as the different workspace ideas, like you kind of have with ClickUp, what you have is folders here that then can, so walls can be put into folders, and there's also subfolder options for it. So if I added another folder here, example, you can actually have many, many layers of subfolders, unlike with ClickUp where you can only have like the 1/2, I believe it's at 1 at the moment, but you've never really been able to do like really a lot of folders within folders. So this is nice from an objective point of view. It's good to have more options, but I still think that this application has some problems. There's no integrations with this application. It's really nice for brainstorming, and that's good, but there's not much you can do in regards to like getting maybe these ideas and moving it to something like Notion, which I think honestly this is just a little bit better of a visual view. But here's the thing. What if Notion just made a gallery page that you can interact with? Where then does this app fit in? Because the one thing I think it's got going for it is that it's a little bit more aesthetic, and that you can interact with a brick, which is like a page. What if Notion just had their galleries have that capability? It's better. in that way. So I have a problem with the fact that it doesn't have any integrations with anything, because it's one thing is like small pages. Like I could just take a Obsidian page and like separate some different pages as well and segment them similarly. If we go into the mobile app, it actually shows where it can shine. So what's really cool is the fact that like you can interact with this daily desk, and it's so snappy and like quick and easy to use, unlike with Notion. So getting ideas and like jotting ideas out and putting different things in here. Look on Amazon for lamps. Like you could just do stuff like this really quickly, and it works fast. And you can navigate through folders and look at tasks and bookmarks really quickly. Like this bookmark section is actually a really nice one to look at. And it does have a very snappy and aesthetic appeal to it on the mobile app. So I think this could be an application where you just take different ideas, jot them down, and then move into another application. Like it's cool that you can then see your pinned ones, where like this is really easy to just go into different bookmarks that you'd maybe have and different brainstorming areas. Like I could quickly go in here and do a Coda versus Walling review. And this is something to just be able to jot down and interact with easily. But here's the thing, an application like this has a good spot for somebody. I just think that for $5 a month to get the real functionality out of it, I don't know if it's worth it. I would maybe just go for the free plan. And if you prefer jotting ideas down like this on your phone and then like moving it into the visual space on the PC with something else, maybe do that. Even using it as a just a brainstorming board is pretty solid, but don't expect project management or anything else like that out of this application. Other ones are better.
If you like this video and want to see more on other productivity apps, make sure to click this one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.